Hello student, welcome back. I am Mrs. Harsha Jope from Praveen Patil Polytechnic, Bhayandar. Today we are going to study next part of our chapter 2, Raster Scan Graphics. Learning outcomes of these videos are, after watching this video, you will be able to know about what is frame buffer, what is the definition of frame buffer, and what is scan conversion method. In last video, we have studied about scan line algorithm. Let's start our topic, frame buffer. On this topic, a question can be asked like that, define frame buffer for 2 marks. Then the definition of frame buffer, it can be in 2 ways. The frame buffer is the video memory, that is RAM, that is used to hold or map the image displayed on the screen. Means what? Frame buffer is nothing but the memory area. And what that memory area will hold? It will hold or map the image displayed on the screen. This is the one definition of frame buffer. And in another way, you can write a frame buffer, or sometimes it is called as a frame store. It's a portion of RAM containing a bitmap that drives a video display. Both the definition are same. Main concept is, what is a frame buffer? It just a memory area. It is a memory area that is used to hold the image which is displayed on the screen. Means, if on your screen a particular image is shown, then where the image is stored, it is stored in a frame buffer. As we know, pixel is the smallest piece of information in an image. Pixel is even a smallest dot on the screen. Okay, we know this, that on our screen, number of pixels are present. Consider that this is your screen. You can see this is your screen. Okay. Then this screen is divided into number of tiny parts that are called as the pixels. Pixels are normally arranged in a regular 2D grid and are often represented using dots or squares. Okay, consider that this is our screen, and on this screen the grid is made. Grid, it consists of the number of vertical lines and the number of horizontal lines. Then, what is a pixel? This particular portion, it is called as a pixel. Okay. Each screen pixel corresponds to a particular entry in a 2D array residing in memory. This memory is called as a frame buffer or a bitmap. Then next topic is scan conversion. Scan conversion, it is the process of representing continuous graphics object as a collection of discrete pixels is called as a scan conversion. For example, a line is defined by its two endpoints and the line equation. Okay, where as a circle is defined by its radius, center position and circle equation. It is the responsibility of graphic system or the application program to convert each primitive from its geometric definition into a set of pixels that make up the primitive in image space. Means what? We know what is the equation of line, okay? But with the help of equation, we can't draw the line. We need to convert that equation into the set of pixels that will draw the image, that will draw the line. So, this conversion task, that is to convert the image equation or the starting and ending point into the particular image on a screen. It is called as a scan conversion or rasterization. Okay. In line drawing algorithm, we have seen that we know the starting point and we know the ending point. And we convert this point into the line by using the rasterization method, by using some rasterization algorithm that is called as a rasterization or a scan conversion. In case of line, it can be possible that any pixel may have a floating value like 2.7, this which will not be considered by the system. Therefore, the process of making the coordinates according to the system's assumptions, that is 3,5, to plot the pixel is the scan conversion. Here, in scan conversion, this floating value, that is the 2.7, it is converted to the 3. That is called as a scan conversion method. The next is a scan converting a point. Before starting this topic, we will see what is a floor function. Floor of x, that is a floor of any number, what this function will do, it will rounds the number x down. For example, floor of 1.6 equal to 1. Floor of 2.7 is 2. Then scan converting a point. As in the mathematical, we know that a point is represented as a real number. And in the scan conversion, we convert the real number into floor of a point. I already explained what is the floor function. The floor is the smallest and equal to a number when we convert a number. Suppose that there is a point x, y, it's a coordinate, that point. Then we convert into the floor, then it will be x dash, y dash. For example, x dash equal to, floor of x and y dash equal to floor of y. For example, there are the points of P1, 1.7, 0.8. This is your P1. Point 2, this is your P2, 2.2, 1.3, and this is your P3, 2.8, 1.9. Then, after finding the floor of those points, P1 will be 1, 0. 1, 0. P2 will be, what it will be? After flooring, 2, 1. We have to round the number down. 2.8, it will be 2, 1.9, it will be 1. These are the points that is called as a scan converting a point. Okay, then in today's lecture, we have studied about what is a frame buffer and what is scan conversion and scan converting a point. Thank you for watching this video.